afternoon, everyone. I'm Duke of the Bump. It is 2:05 p.m. here on the eastern side of the United States on August 12th, 2017. Welcome to my very first ASMR Let's Play. This is Desert Golfing. This came out, I believe, in 2013 or 2014. Most notably on iOS and Android devices. However, I'll be playing the version on the Windows 10 store, which is $2.99. I already own the game on Android, but I decided the best way to record it would be to download the Windows 10 version. It's not on Steam or otherwise available for PC platforms. It's only available in the Windows Store. Although I believe if you have Windows 8 or maybe 8.1, you should still be able to purchase this game. This is episode number 1 of, well, see how many holes I get through in the first episode before we start making plans. What you see on the screen is the title slash tutorial. This level does not count towards your overall score. So I can get used to the physics and controlling the angle of the ball with the mouse. Because in the past, I've only played this game on a touchscreen. I didn't intend to place the ball in the tutorial hole that quickly. But that's okay. Welcome to hole number 1. And I believe the right side of the game is cut off in the recording. So let me see if I can adjust that without disturbing the video too much. Okay, that's too much. Let's say that's close enough. So the object of Desert Golfing is to place the ball in the cup or the hole. The graphics are kind of minimal, so it's hard to tell if this is actually a cup or if it's just a hole someone dug in the ground. You drag the mouse cursor to control your trajectory. I have the mouse cursor turned off in the recording for a cleaner video. But right now, my mouse cursor is right at the very tip of the dotted line, and the arrow indicates the direction and the power of the ball. And it may take a while for me to get used to the physics playing in a larger window with a different input device. But I'm sure it won't affect my score too badly. The more shots I miss, the more you get to enjoy the gentle sound of the ball rolling across the sand. So, the previous goal, the cup or the hole, becomes the new starting point for hole number two, and the screen shifts forward to another part of the desert. If you hit the ball off of the screen, it will reappear on this tiny gray pad. Now let's begin hole number two. Just a little too much power on that one. If this wasn't an ASMR video, I would probably say too much power. In a manner reminiscent of Tim the Toolman Taylor from the 1990s comedy television show Home Improvement. Too much power, or more power, as the case may call for, was one of Tim's catchphrases. He was, of course, played by Tim Allen. So his name was Tim in the show, but also in real life. This would lead to many hilarious bloopers where he would accidentally call other characters in the show by the name of the actor or actress who plays that character, because his name is Tim, both in reality and in the fiction. So, for example, his wife in the show, the character Jill, he would sometimes call Pat, because the name of the actress who played Jill was Patricia. But she went by Pat for short. So far, I'm averaging par two on every hole, which isn't the best for these early levels. They're relatively simple. Oh, yes. And a hole-in-one should be feasible on several of them. Lucky number 7, yes. maybe wondering why I'm playing this instead of Wonder Boy and Monster World, The Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall, or even Eye of the Beholder. And the explanation for that also happens to be related to Windows 10. But for me to succeed at this hole, I'm going to have to play more cautiously, use a stroke just to get the ball closer to the green, or the metaphorical green, because it's actually very sandy. There we go. So Windows 10, which I upgraded to from my OEM copy of Windows 7 that came with my computer, Windows 10 has an interesting feature, at least for me, where every couple of months, all of the networking functionality of Windows starts to fail. And at first I thought it was my Wi-Fi USB adapter or dongle, because I had not previously used a Wi-Fi adapter on my desktop computer. But my current living situation necessitates a cleaner solution than running hundreds of feet of Ethernet cable. Now this is a very easy hole. It's just a straight line from the beginning to the target. This should not take me more than a single stroke. Even if I overshoot, it should roll down that little hill. And that wasn't even necessary. So as I was saying, I thought the problem was with my wireless internet adapter or dongle. But I tried using a second wireless router or hub. I think it's technically a router to bridge the Wi-Fi connection with my computer. And that was going through the Ethernet port of my computer. It was not a USB device. And the same pattern was repeating even with the bridge solution. It would work fine for a couple months. And then Windows would slowly begin to give me DNS errors. Infrequently at first, but then more and more frequently, until my internet connection became, for all intents and purposes, unusable. I need higher angle for the shot. I'm underestimating steepness of the slope. So when my internet connection becomes unusable, whether using the USB device or the wireless bridge, the only solution I can find to this problem is reinstalling Windows 10, which isn't the biggest tragedy in the world. Windows 10 makes it relatively easy to reinstall. You just go into the recovery menu or the recovery section of the settings menu, and there's an option to refresh Windows back to its original state, because it keeps a copy of that original state of Windows 10 on your hard drive. It does not require a disk. So, with no other solutions and no apparent way to roll back to Windows 7, I resigned myself to just having Windows on my main hard drive, which is an SSD, solid state drive, and all of my games, or most of my games, the smaller games like Desert Golfing, I can just put on the SSD. Because despite having over 17,000 levels, this game is a mere 600 kilobytes. This entire game takes up less hard drive space than 1 second of the video that you are currently watching. I don't know if that math exactly checks out, but I am recording in a cool, smooth 60 frames per second. So you get all of that smooth, smooth golf action. Anyway, I would keep Windows on my C drive, which is an arbitrary letter designation. You can go in and change the letters of your hard drives to whatever you want. But by default, my solid state drive was C, and the hard drive that I keep most of my data on and all of my larger games is the D drive. And it worked fine. I would occasionally have to reinstall Windows 10 to get the network functionality to work. But all of my important data remained on the D drive. And anything important on the C drive, I would be sure to back up to the D drive. For example, the Elder Scrolls II Daggerfall is a very old game. It does not take up a lot of hard drive space, much like Desert Golfing. Because like Desert Golfing, much of that game is procedurally generated, meaning a lot of the actual stuff that you do in the game is generated on the fly by mathematical algorithms. This is popular among programmers, there was a scene called the demo scene where people made very impressive graphical and audio art that's largely generated by math, so it takes up a very small portion of the hard drive, or a small amount of bits in general. Anyway, when it came time to reinstall Windows 10 to get the internet working again, I would, of course, back up all of my Elder Scrolls data, my save files. All of my videos aren't already on that hard drive, because there's a small chance that YouTube will disappear and I will no longer have those videos. And I need a better, longer-term backup solution, but I don't yet. Anyway, long story short, the last time I reinstalled Windows 10, some things happened. I foolishly decided that I was sick of having to go through this process every 2 months, and I decided that I would attempt to roll back to Windows 7, even though Microsoft strongly discourages this, and they will not allow you to roll back to Windows 7 except for like the first 90 days after I used Windows 10 or something like that. But I thought, well, all I have to do is, oh my gosh. The nice thing about this game is it's relaxing. You don't have to worry about your score. Right now I have less than a 50% shot to point ratio, but it's okay. This game doesn't judge. But like a madman, I thought that all I would have to do is download a archival copy of Windows 7, put the ISO on a thumb drive, because I, of course, do not have any blank DVDs laying around, and boot that thumb drive, format my C drive, leave the D drive intact, and it would just overwrite my C drive, delete every trace of Windows 10, and I would have Windows 7 again. And I won't bore you with the details, because I know this has been a very exciting video, and I would not want to turn it into something less exciting. Long story short, I didn't end up installing Windows 7. I tried to, but Windows 10 changed something in my computer, and I don't understand what. And it would not allow me to continue the Windows 7 installation. It had something to do with some sort of file allocation table or some sort of, I don't know what NTFS stands for. Well, I assume it's Windows NT file system, but I don't know what the NT stands for. But anyway, Windows 7, and I think going back as far as Windows 2000, use the NTFS format for its file allocation tables, which is just a fancy way of talking about how the operating system stores data on the hard drive. In Windows 10, the malware, the virus, the officially sanctioned Microsoft Voodoo curse went in and scrambled all of the file allocation tables, and Windows 7 would not install. It would not even overwrite those sections of the hard drive. And I'm sure I could have used a program like DBAN, which is, I don't know what the D stands for, but BAN stands for boot and nuke. It's a small program that you install on a USB thumb drive, and it completely not only formats the hard drive, but overwrites all of the data so that nothing can be recovered in the event of someone getting access to your hard drive. Because even after it's been formatted, it still contains traces, ghosts of all of the old data. And it's for security for people who have sensitive data on their hard drives. But it's available for free, and anyone can use it to kind of wipe the slate clean when they need to. And I could have done that, but after all of the hassle that I went through, because it wasn't a matter of simply starting up my computer with the thumb drive in the USB slot. Oh no. I had to go into the BIOS and change the settings to boot from the USB drive first rather than the hard drive, which I knew. I've done this before, so I was prepared to do that. And much to my chagrin, I was not able to access the BIOS because the USB keyboard was not being recognized until after the Windows boot process. And my Windows installation was already mangled beyond hope at this point, because I had attempted to install Windows 7 over top, or not over top, but I attempted to install Windows 7 over Windows 10. I wanted to roll back instead of having to completely restart the installation process, and that didn't work. So I thought, okay, I'll go into my BIOS, I'll change Change the settings to allow booting from a USB drive. Oh, look at that shot. That would have been much more impressive if I didn't have 4 missed shots before it. So long story short, it took me forever to figure out how to even get into the BIOS. Because at this point, I did not have a functional Windows installation. And I know that I should have done my research. I should have realized that it wasn't going to be that simple. Because this is Microsoft we're dealing with. But I tried it anyway. But okay, I figured out how to make my USB keyboard be recognized by the computer so I could get into the BIOS. It involved holding the reset button for a certain amount of time after I pressed the power button. And I got into the BIOS, and I changed the settings, and I tried to reinstall Windows 7, or install Windows 7, over top of Windows 10. I wanted to just format the hard drive. You know, I don't have any sensitive information. I don't need to do a complete boot and nuke, because that process takes a long time. So I thought, okay, I'll just have the Windows 7 installer that I boot from the USB drive format my C drive. All of the Windows installation data was on the thumb drive, so it should have worked, but it didn't, and it has something to do with those file allocation tables. So finally, I'd been working all day at this point. I was frustrated. I just wanted my computer back. And I said to myself, Duke or Matt. I call myself both when I refer to myself in the third person, both or either Duke and Matt. I said Duke/Matt. This has been the most frustrating thing I've done all year, or you've done all year, because I'm still in third-person mode. And I said to myself, I just want my computer back and working again. And I don't want to go through the process of downloading boot and nuke on another computer, because remember, my main computer is non-operational, and I didn't want to do the long process of doing the boot and nuke to completely overwrite all the data. And I just noticed that the bottom of the screen is cut off a little bit too. And I'd like to apologize officially for that. I did not even realize. I was so focused on my golf game and telling old war stories about terrible technology. I don't think this window will resize to a 16:9 aspect ratio, which is a little disappointing. I can drag the bottom of the screen up, but then you won't be able to see my score, which is very important. Another fine Microsoft product. The Windows app universe is, well, it's not very good. Anyway, long story short, because I'm running out of time, I said, okay, I'll just deal with Windows 10, and I'll deal with having to reinstall Windows 10 every 2 months, and I'll just keep everything important on my D drive, and it'll be fine. I just want my computer back. But sometime... Oh, that's a sweet tin cup, baby. Sometime during the whole process of trying to figure out this Kafka-esque nightmare of an operating system, at some point, I had erased or overwritten or formatted my D drive, and I lost my Daggerfall saves. I lost the Eye of the Beholder save that I was still holding on to. I lost my Wonder Boy and Monster World save, because that was installed to a Steam library on my D drive, and the Genesis Classics, the Mega Drive Genesis Classics on Steam does not have Steam Cloud Save support. So, yeah, I lost all of those. I didn't lose anything irreplaceable. Anything irreplaceable, well, other than those saves, of course. But I didn't lose anything. I mean, I can get back to that point in Daggerfall. I can get back to that point in Wonder Boy and Monster World. I didn't lose anything of sentimental value or important financial value, because I keep all of that backed up to a Dropbox account, because it's not very large. It's a few things that I work on, and my backup for my password manager, and a few other small things, mostly text files or small graphics, small image files, a few photographs, and it's easy enough to keep it all backed up to Dropbox. And it would have been easy enough to keep all of my saves backed up to Dropbox as well. But, oh my gosh. So frustrating when it's a hole in one, but then it bounces out of the cup. If I could give the creator of this game one piece of feedback, it would be to make the cup or the hole deep enough that the ball is not able to bounce out. And if you get it in the cup, it's going to be a point. Because it's already unrealistic that this platform just rises out of the ground, rises out of where that hole used to be. You might as well make the hole deep enough that when you get that satisfying experience of nailing that hole in one, it doesn't bounce out of the hole and disappoint you. That's my only criticism, though. Other than that, Desert Golfing is a perfect game, and you should buy it on iOS or Android. Or, if you have no other options, the Windows Store. Nice. Although, in my current state of mind, I cannot really endorse anything involving Windows. And there was a brief period of time after I realized that I had somehow accidentally erased my D drive. I thought I would take a stand and just become a person who uses Linux. And then I realized how few of the 300 or so computer games that I own digitally through Valve's Steam distribution service actually would work on Linux natively. I think it was less than 25%, which is still pretty impressive considering a few years ago it would have been 0%. And I'm sure several of the games would work on Wine or some other type of virtual machine, but I like playing games. I enjoy playing games, and I want the process of playing games and recording games and streaming games and making games to be as seamless as possible. And I want everything to work smoothly, and I know from experience that... Oh, thought my ball was going off the edge of the screen. I was expecting it to respawn on the left side. I know from experience that trying to get things to work in Linux can be a trying experience in its own way. Not as frustrating, of course, as dealing with Windows, but it presents a new set of challenges that I was, in my mind state at the time, unprepared to face. So Windows 10 it is, at least for now. And I'm sorry I lost all of my video game saves, but you'll be pleased to know that the video game that I'm working on creating is fully intact, because that was important enough for me to back up in another location. And now that I've had this experience, I will be less choosy about what I deem important enough to back up to the cloud. And I can get back to where I was in Daggerfall. I mostly just messed around in dungeons for hours anyway. And I was really not that far into Eye of the Beholder or Wonder Boy, so I'm not that upset about my lost progress, but you asked for an explanation of why I was not playing one of those games, and that is the explanation. I'm sorry to have kept it so terse. I would like to go into the explanation in greater detail, but of course, we have Desert Golf to play. The video has been going for about 45 minutes. I'm on hole number 78. My point ratio, or my point to stroke ratio, is worse than 2/1, which is okay. Once I get used to the physics and controlling it with the mouse, I should be able to start getting more holes in one and bring my ratio back to something closer to 2/1, or 50%, or However ratios work. It would be 1/2. But right now, I'm on hole number 80, and I have 193 strokes. So my average is a little more than 2 strokes per hole. But that's okay, because like I said, desert golfing does not judge. It's not here to make fun of you for your poor performance. There are no leaderboards. There are no daily challenges. There's not even a high score list locally. You just play, and the numbers keep going up, and see what the world of desert golfing has to offer. And I know it's been mostly featureless sand against a featureless beige sky. And I'm not going to spoil anything, but this game does have a few surprises later on, which we will discover together through this 170 part series, because there are 17,000 holes, and if I do 100 holes per video, it'll take me 170 videos to get to the end. And I believe that theoretically there's an infinite number of levels. Much like The Elder Scrolls II Daggerfall, this game is not procedurally generated as you play. As in, say, a roguelike. Or a procedural death labyrinth. All of the levels were procedurally generated beforehand and then baked into the game. So everyone has the same 17,000 levels and possibly more, but once you get to hole number 17,000 or so, I forget what the exact number is, there is an unbeatable level. Because, as you can already see, the geometry of the levels, it's a little bit more complex as you continue through the game, and you do still have levels that are fairly simple, because of course it is randomly generated. And I know the author of the game has some level of quality control, but you can't manually check all X number of levels in your game. And as it just so happens, there is an unbeatable level around hole number 17,000, which is considered by most people to be the end of the game for all intents and purposes. But on the way to the death screen, it is a journey of exploration. What will we find in this desert? What secrets does this desert hide? Is Frog Fractions 3 buried somewhere in this game? No. Because this game was last updated in 2015. However, the secrets in this game might blow your mind anyway. We're on hole number 88. We are at the number needed to travel through time. We're now on hole number 89. We have gone past the time barrier. The flux capacitor is in full gear. I don't know why it has gears. I ordered my flux capacitor off eBay, so it might not be 100% genuine. But it is enabling me to travel through time. We have already traveled through time 51 minutes and 27 seconds on our journey through desert golfing and my computer woes and my first attempt at ASMR. Some people say that I have a relaxing voice naturally, and I've been told that people sometimes use my videos to help them fall asleep. And I used to take umbrage with that a little bit, but I've come to embrace it as a compliment. I like being relaxing, and I like helping people chill out because it's a stressful world. And any assistance one can get in their relaxation, I think, is a service to the world. So, this is the first time I'm actually trying to be relaxing on purpose, and I don't know how good it is, because to tell you the truth, I don't get the auto-sensory meridian response. I think that's what ASMR stands for. It's the tingly feeling that some people get. But I can enjoy ASMR videos, and I do enjoy ASMR videos just for their general relaxation-inducing qualities. So that's what I'm trying to attempt to do. Yes, trying to attempt. We're not going to worry about redundancies, because this is desert golfing. This is a no-judgment zone. No one cares that I'm on hole 99 and I have 247 strokes, because we're just hanging out and having a good time. And I hope you've had a good time too. I know I have. Hopefully you are adrift in slumberland by now. I'm sure no one is actually listening to this 54 minutes into the video who's actually conscious. But if you are, then I hope that the journey was worth it. I hope that it was a pleasant experience. And I hope you look forward to the 170 hours we have to go. This is, of course, assuming that my progress stays as steady as it has been, and I can bang out 100 levels in about an hour in the future. I suppose we'll see. Anyway, I'm Duke of the Bump. This has been Let's Play Desert Golfing ASMR Edition. I hope you've enjoyed the relaxing sounds of the ball hitting sand, and hopefully the relaxing sounds of my voice. And if you have any feedback or comments or complaints or questions or praise, feel free to leave it in the comments below. YouTube comments are, by and large, a pretty terrible place, but I leave my comments open because everyone who watches my videos so far has been pretty cool, and I know that if you do have constructive criticism, then you're not going to be a jerk about it. And I know that some of the sound effects in this game can be a little jarring relative to the softness of the rest of the tone of the video. I'm going to waste a stroke to demonstrate one of the sound effects that I don't like. That little bloop sound when the ball reappears. It's not a bad sound, it's just incongruous with the whole ASMR relaxation experience. But I hope it's not too jarring. I also increased the volume gain because another great feature of Windows 10 seems to be that I cannot adjust the volume for this game individually in the Windows volume mixer because ? So I turned up the gain a little bit in OBS and I tested it and it didn't seem too loud. And I mean, it's not like there are many sound effects in this game anyway, but I just want it to be the most orally pleasing experience. That's AURALLY of Desert Golfing that you can find on the internet today. So, again, I'm Duke of the Bump, signing off. I will start live streaming again soon. I'm not sure what game it's going to be. It's not going to be this. This is not a streaming game. This is a relax and hang out together and enjoy the sunset kind of game. So, keep an eye on Duke.Zone or the Twitter or Facebook accounts, although I hate Twitter and Facebook, and I don't like using them. Join the Steam group, or you can also send me a text message at 304-986-5854. And just say that you would like me to text you when the stream begins, and I will be happy to oblige. So, take care, everyone. Have a good night, or a good evening, or a time zone appropriate sign off for you. And I will see you in one form or another soon.